Hello there. I'm down at Hatchlands over on the Silver Lake, and I'm just having a little dabble this afternoon, just for 2 or 3 hours, and I'm trying out to see whether my little maggot rig on the Ultralight fly rod will beat the drop shot rig. Got an adaptation of that, and I'll run that through later.
Thank you. The maggot that I use for this experiment is slightly different to the one that I normally use. I added a small underbody, also made of funky foam, and I used it to make the taper of the maggot a little bit more realistic. I also used less wraps for the segments of the body. Instead of adding 4 or 5 wraps, I only used a couple. And what I also did is I didn't use any black thread at the end, I tied off in the same colour. Once I had, I then used a grey permanent marker and I coloured the tail grey, but I also put a line down the back of the maggot and I also put a trigger spot on it. 2 breathing holes I added to the top with black milk tip as per normal, but what I also did is I went over the whole body with Deer Creek UV resin and then set it, obviously, with UV light. What I found was that it sealed it beautifully. It gave the maggot a little bit of a sheen, but it also left the maggot still chewy if a fish went to take it. I also made sure that I tied it on a size 12 hook so that it was a little bit smaller than the hooks I'd been using previously. The drop shot rig that I use is also different to the drop shot rig that most people are used to. I replaced the Palomar knot with a T-knot, and the thing with this is it presents a loop straight out from the main line. I slid the doubled strands of the loop through the eye of the hook, over the point, and then brought it back to secure the hook firmly in position. I then shrouded the join with a piece of silicone rubber tubing. Very thin, and no reason to alarm the fish at all. Certainly far less alarming than trying to close its lips upon 2 pieces of line above and below the hook, which is what you would get if you used a Palomar knot. At the end of the day, I'd had 7 roach, a rudd, a perch, and 2 bream on the fly rod, and on the drop shot rod, I'd had a single carp. So really, in terms of numbers, the fly did a much better job, certainly in keeping me occupied. In terms of size of fish, if that's what you go for, then yes, I only caught one on the drop shot rig, but that one was probably the weight of all the other fish combined and probably a little bit left over. So it depends on what you want, really, whether you want a numbers game or whether you want a weight game. Entirely up to you. A point of interest is actually on the day, there was a gentleman fishing the other side of me, and he was using 2 rods, one of which was a ledger on the bottom per carp, and the other one of which was a waggler set up for roach and rudd. He was fishing before I came, he was fishing after I left, and the whole of that time he caught 1 rudd. And actually, I thought he was in the best spot. It was certainly the spot that I wanted to get to. Anyway, there you be. The drop shot rig that I use depends on the T-knot for its success. The next 2 diagrams, which I'll leave up for enough time for you to have a good look at, contains the tying instructions for this. It's easier, I think, to look at the diagrams than go through with a fine bit of nylon. Perhaps that might be another video for me to make another day. In the meantime, thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you would like to subscribe, it would be very much appreciated. So thank you for that. Goodbye.